All right, DW Warriors, we are excited to have you get back in the building. I do want you to remember that there are three W's. Wear a mask, wash your hands, and watch your distance. I'm going to talk to you today about some of the different procedures and processes we have here at Daniel Wright to get you into the building safely. The first thing is that if you are coming on a bus or if you are being driven in a car, you will enter Daniel Wright property from the southernmost entrance. You will actually then go clockwise around the building. Just like you have in the past when you've ridden the buses go clockwise and drop you off at different doors. We actually will be emailing you to let you know which door you should get dropped off at. That we will have students enter the building in different places, and that place will be close to where your classroom pod will be located. Before you leave your home, make sure you review the COVID-19 symptoms checklist. We want to make sure that you're not feeling sick or have any of those symptoms before you come to the building. Before entering the building, we need all students and staff to put on masks. When you enter the building, you will access a sanitation station where you can wash your hands with soap and water, or you can use one of our sanitation areas and put sanitizer on your hands. Once you are inside of the buildings, we will not be using student lockers. That you will actually bring your backpack with all of your school supplies in it, and you will take your backpack into your classroom. Once you arrive into your classroom, we ask that students do continue to maintain a 6-foot social distancing, and your teacher will be taking your temperature. If you don't feel well, or you show any of these symptoms on our COVID-19 checklist, we ask that you don't come to school. However, we realize that sometimes during the day, symptoms may develop. So if you find that you're showing any of these symptoms, or when you got your temperature taken, it was over 100.4, you will come here to the main office to see the nurse. To accommodate safe social distancing in a 6-foot space, we are using non-traditional areas in Daniel Wright for classrooms. One of the spaces that has been transformed into a classroom is our new library space. Another space that we'll be using for one of our instructional pods is our new STEM lab. Another space that we will be using for a classroom is our stage. Students will not only be in their classrooms for their core instruction throughout the day, students will also eat lunch in their classrooms. We are providing each student with a plexiglass barrier that they can set up on their personal space so that during lunchtime, they can take their masks off and enjoy their lunch and a mask break. Although students will spend most of the day in their pod classroom, there are times that you may need to move through the hallways to get to a creative art, health, or PE class. When students are moving through the hallways, we ask that you stay to the right and you move in opposite directions and maintain your 6 feet social distancing while you are walking through the hallways. Although our students get to take advantage of PE, we will not be changing this year, so students will not need to change. We ask that when you come down to PE that you can store your items outside of the locker rooms and head into the gym. We also are going to do the best we can to take advantage of our outdoor spaces, and we ask that students consider bringing appropriate clothing for outdoors, a jacket when it gets a little chillier, a hat or gloves. As long as the weather permits, we would like to be able to give students as many mask breaks and stretch breaks throughout the day outside. For our visitors to Daniel Wright, we do ask that when you come into the main vestibule that you actually take your temperature. We do have wipes for you to be able to wipe down the thermometer before and after you take a touchless temperature. Once you've taken your personal temperature, you'll sign in with our secretaries and come into the main office if you are meeting with someone. If you are a student who is coming late to school, or you are a parent that is signing your child out early, we have made it easy for you to do so with signs posted here in our vestibule. Scanning this QR code accesses a Google form and you can input your child's information and the reason for either their early release or late arrival. We will also have these QR codes posted externally on the outside of the building to limit the number of people that do need to come into the building. So very simply, you can scan the QR code and access the Google form to sign your child in or out of school.